Might get a little annoyed that I'm wearing the exact same thing that you will see me wear in my September favorites because it's been recorded like back to back, but I hope you guys don't mind because I am just really liking my makeup and outfit today. Go figure. So, I wanted to make a fairly quick products I regret buying number 8 video. It's been that many, can you believe it? The last one that I posted in July, you guys really liked it, so I figured why not? The first product I wanted to talk about would be something I really wanted to do a review video, even if it was a short love it or leave it one, but it just didn't work out that way. It's a new drugstore product and it's from Maybelline. It's the Brow Drama and I have shade Blonde. It is a tinted brow gel. It has the weirdest wand ever. It's like, okay, is that a fruit fly? The wand is not like a teardrop. It has like a scary looking spiky ball with smaller bristles at the end, so I guess kind of help comb out the brow. I don't really know. I had such high hopes for this, or you know, just decent hopes. It is sticky. I don't like that it makes my brow sticky. It's not a good sticky. It's not like a wax sticky, because this has a nice little hold itself too, but this one, it just looks very artificial and fake. And if anything, I'd like this to look more natural. Maybe this is better for someone who likes to apply a, you know, tinted brow mascara over their brows after they've already used something else, or maybe they have, you know, thicker brows naturally and this is just good to kind of give it a little shape. But for my brows, which aren't that sparse, the inner corners look all funny because I don't have a lot of hair there, and then the outer corners look kind of sticky. Sadly, not my thing. I purchased all the other shades and I ended up returning them before opening them because I was like, it's not. I'm just gonna hold up one, but if you've watched this video, you know what brush set I'm talking about. This is why this brush, this exact one, is the one that I purchased the brush set from Target for $40 for. It's an okay brush. I wish it was a little, I don't know, different. I wouldn't mind just keeping this brush, but I think I'm gonna give it away to vlog channel viewers. I'm just gonna wash them all and ask if anyone wants them and do a run of giveaway on that video because I have a lot of brushes and it's just not something I need to hang on to, the set itself. But yeah, I don't know. I felt like Sonia Kashuk has really good brushes, but their individual brushes are a lot better than their sets. It's just like MAC, like their individual brushes are way better than their travel sets. At least to me. I know a lot of people love the brush, so a lot of people did not like the fact that I was kind of being a little too honest in the video that I was mentioning. It happens. Next thing is a Bite Matte Lip Crayon, and this is from Sephora in a dark, dark purple shade. It's very similar to what I'm wearing on my lips, actually. Very similar. So, first and foremost, they're not matte at all. If anything, they're like a semi-matte, like after a while, but they apply glossy and smooth, which is cool. Don't really care for the scent. It's like ridiculously fake, fruity, nasty lipstick scent combined. I don't know. I can wear lipstick all the time, but this is just not something I want on. Kind of weird because I like another shade it has and the scent itself isn't as strong. I don't know if it's like the darker the shade, the more the fragrance is, or fragrance. Beautiful shade, but it applies horribly. It applies patchy and streaky, and with dark shades, you don't want that because it will cling on to any drier or flaky patches you have on your lip and just look uneven, and that's exactly what this color does, so not happy with it whatsoever. These Flower Cosmetics Velvet Lip Chubbies. I love the word chubby. Like, when it comes to makeup, not people. I would never say that. Unless, you know, someone wanted me to. But anyway, this. I don't know, it looks so good on Judy from It's Judy Time. And I just want to say that there's nothing wrong with the formulation of them. It's just all the shades look horrible on me. I bought 4 out of 5 shades available at my Walmart. Surprisingly, the reds look horrible on me. There's something about them being a little bit more orangey. And usually I can pull off a lot of reds, but these are just not my reds. I was really disappointed that, you know, they just look so good. Like, these look like shades I wear all the time. Flower Cosmetics, if you're listening, maybe make more shades for girls that look like me. I'd appreciate it. Thanks. Next thing, downstairs. I know, bad YouTuber I am. Posting a picture. It is by Ojon. Ojon is one of my favorite hair brand, or I'll just say I like it because of this hair serum. You might have seen it in my Get Ready With Me for my birthday. This is the little sample size. I'm gonna buy the full size. I'm gonna return that hair mask for the full size of this because the hair mask is also in their Damage Reverse line, and I was like, oh, I want it. It's only $20. Not bad. And it's just like coconut oil. It's a little bit tougher at room temperature. You rub it between your hands, turns into oil, rub it on, but it's thicker. It's not like coconut oil to the point where it's like, oh, it's sliding. It's like clay, almost. I did not see any results from it. I get results from coconut oil easily. But that mask did not do anything for me, which makes me sad because I love the oil. The oil gives me life. It's what I need, but the mask itself did nothing. So I was very disappointed in that. And that's a very recent purchase too. These are the Sally Hansen Miracle Gel Polishes. Fairly new, comes in a lot of shades. I have not given up to the point where I'm like, I will never use it again, but honestly, I don't like these. I tried to film a video yesterday, an application, and I was gonna do a wear test, see how long they wear. I was very excited. Everyone was requesting some sort of review video. I couldn't do it. My nails couldn't last. It was so bad. I kept having to repaint them. I repainted them maybe three to four times almost yesterday. And it wasn't because I was like hitting my hands into things. Hours after I put the top coat on, which you're supposed to use the top coat, the Miracle Gel top coat, and it's supposed to not, you know, have to use UV lights for a gel finish. I wanted to grab my Sheet so badly because it took forever to dry, it kept getting nicked, and it was applying streaky. And what I did not like about it, because it's a gel formula, you don't want to apply too much. But the shades, maybe it's the shades I picked. I picked a B-Girl, which is turquoise, and then a white, which is Get Mod. Hard shades to master. I got these shades because I do not have any good polishes formula-wise in these shades. Like, all the turquoises are usually kind of streaky, I mean, aside from Mint Candy Apple. And this one, it's a little streaky and it's sheer just like the other ones. Takes a million coats, at least three, sometimes four. And that's too much because it says only to apply two. And even with two, it doesn't look good and it still doesn't dry. The white one applies streaky until about the second to third coat. But you can see the streaks after you put the top coat on. And that's my issue. It looks good until you put the top coat on and you're like, huh? Huh? Why? I don't get it. It's a blower and I kept trying to make it work. And then in the shower, as soon as I got in the shower, and I would say I had like a 4-hour gap before I got in the shower, they all like start peeling off, literally like clay, not clay, but like a gel. It was, well, there's no way I can do a wear test if they won't stay on my fingers. So they were the inspiration for this video today. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video.